Hello, this video is going to show how quick and easy it is to set up your cloud-hosted HollaEx exchange. So to start off here, I'm quickly going through the setup of this new exchange through the HollaEx dashboard. If you want some guidance on these steps, there is a video on the YouTube channel. With the final step, we choose what type of plan we intend on using. I'm going to be sticking with the Crypto Pro for the moment, but this can be changed easily later. Once finished with the initial setup, we'll be greeted with this screen, and we can see some of our options. Clicking this first link, we'll get a comprehensive list of the differences between the three cloud plans. More information on these in the description. And this second link will take us to the hosting page. Here we can switch between cloud or DIY hosting with this toggle. For this video though, we'll be sticking with cloud. So this Go Live button is going to be the launchpad for your exchange, and clicking it, we are going to see two tasks to complete to get going. The first is super simple and quick, just getting our domain set up. So to start off, we will select the built-in domain that comes with HollaEx. This can be changed later to connect to your own custom domain. Next up, we'll be taken to billing to settle the invoice. Let's click that blue pay button and see our options. So first up, we can switch between paying monthly or yearly, remembering that a substantial saving can be obtained by paying yearly. We can also choose what type of plan between Basic, Pro or Fiat Master, with Fiat Master requiring a little more dialogue between you and the HollaEx team due to the nature of its setup. For this video though, let's stick with the Crypto Pro plan and pay it monthly. We have some options now, paying by PayPal or bank transfer, but let's go with the crypto option to get a 10% discount. We'll choose what currency to pay in, and we can see that by paying in the HollaEx native token, XHT, we will get that 10% off. If you don't have any XHT, it's easy to trade for on the HollaEx official exchange, linked in the description below. Advancing on, we'll get the payment address, and we can move on to sorting that out. So let's copy that address, and I'm going to be paying using my HollaEx Pro wallet. Selecting withdraw with XHT, we'll bring up the screen to let us send tokens. So let's paste that address in, and input the amount we saw on the last screen. It's a good idea here to double check all is in order, the address looks right, and so does the amount. So let's review that and make sure we're all happy with it. And I'm going to fast forward the confirmation steps here. Once that's all confirmed, we can go into our withdrawal history, and on a refresh, we can see it at the top of my screen here. Clicking view on the right of the list item for our transaction will bring us to the Etherscan screen, and we can see the transaction being processed. It took about 30 seconds for me to get done. So jumping back to the dashboard now. Don't worry if you refresh and it's not updated just yet as having been paid. Have a quick coffee break and it should be grand in about 5 minutes. So with all the nice green paid signs now, let's get back to that Go Live button on the hosting page. So all of our tasks are complete, and now simply let HollaEx take the wheel and to get your exchange up and running. This process took me about 20 minutes or so, so go put your feet up while all the work is done for you. Once it's complete, you'll get an email letting you know that it is. And by going to the domain tab here, we can copy and paste our new exchange's URL into the browser. The first time you bring up the exchange, you'll see this screen. These are just the final bits and pieces before your exchange is ready to be traded on. So first, set up the admin account. Here it's a wise idea to use a separate email that you used for your dashboard account. Enter all the details and we'll see one last settings page. Go through this, check the time zone and locality is correct, set up two-factor authentication, review the assets you chose earlier, choose what features to have, and in this case, as we're on Pro, we'll have access to all of them, and finally, configure your SMTP email if you have this ready to go. Let this final setup go, and hey presto, your exchange is up, running, and ready for your users to trade on.